बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। आई एम योर टीचर मारिया हकान एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द चैप्टर नंबर 6, ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर, प्लीज़ टेल मी व्हाट इज़ ट्रेड। ट्रेड इन्वॉल्व्स द ट्रांसफ़र ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विसेज फ्रॉम वन पर्सन और एंटिटी टू अनदर, often in exchange for money. Or you can also say that trade is basically economic concept involving the buying and selling of goods and services with compensation paid by a buyer to a seller, or the exchange of goods or services between parties. Then there comes the commerce. What is commerce? Commerce is the conduct of trade among economic agents. Generally, commerce refers to the exchange of goods, services, or something of value between business or entities. For example, the social or intellectual exchanges amongst a group of friends. From a broad perspective, nations are concerned with managing commerce in a way that enhances the well-being of citizens by providing jobs and producing beneficial goods and services. Example of commerce is, you can see this picture, it's a clear example of commerce. There's the barter. Barter system is basically the exchanging of goods. And on the other picture, you can see the person is giving the money to own the car. Here's the another clear image to explain what is the commerce. Let's start reading the text. A country's wealth. A country's wealth is very much like that of an ordinary family. We work to earn wages, which we can spend on houses, furniture, food, clothing, travel, entertainment, and so on. But if we spend less than we earn, we have money to save or to spend on holidays, new clothes, and special treats. But if we spend more than we earn, we get into debt and have to borrow from a bank or a money lender. Unfortunately, we have to pay back the money we borrowed plus interest. Same as it is for a country, the wages are called exports. Things it sells overseas. The commodities we buy are called imports, things we buy from other countries. If a country exports more than its imports, it has spare money to buy more imports for developments such as roads or to provide more social services such as welfare, more schools and hospitals for the people. If, however, it buys more from overseas than it sells, it has to borrow from other countries or international organizations such as the World Bank or other United Nations departments. But as its reserves of money are low, it will probably have to pay high interest rates. As we have seen, the wealth of a country comes largely from its export. Some of these are agricultural products such as sugar, rice, wheat, and fruits, most of which are relatively low in value. Some exports such as iron and other metal ores are more valuable. Oil and natural gas, which are really minerals, are of course extremely valuable. But most valuable of all are manufactured products, machinery, motor vehicles, electrical and electronic equipments, chemicals, clothing and textiles, plastics, sports equipments, carpets and much more. These are valuable because although the cost of the raw material in them may not be very great, there is great skill and a lot of expensive machinery involved in making them. The value of export and import set against one another is called balance of payment. A country's which sells more than it buys, it's said to have positive balance payments. If it buys more than it sells abroad, it is said to have negative balance. Another import source of income for a country, especially Pakistan, is money sent home by people who work overseas. Hundreds of thousands of Pakistanis work abroad, especially in the oil industry in Saudi Arabia and the Gulf states, where wages are much higher than they are at home. In 2001, these expatriates sent home about 2 billion. Then there comes the international trade. In the very beginning, I have shown the picture of barter system. I have told you that it was the system of exchanging the goods. But there were some of the advantages and disadvantages of that. Have a look on this picture. The advantage for barter system was easy exchange, instant exchange, limited production. And what was its disadvantage? Like issues of double coincidence of wants, difficulty in storing value, problem of measurement of value. Why do people barter? People traded some of the things they didn't need for things they wanted or needed. Even then, people had different jobs and skills. The good hunter might trade 10 rabbits to the carpenter for the carpenter's promise to fix his roof. It's just an example, okay? Let's start reading the text again. No country in the world can produce everything it needs for its people, even if it can grow enough food. And there are only 5 countries on earth that can do that. It still needs machinery, oil, motor vehicles, raw materials, electronics, and thousands of other things. Trading between countries can much like buying or selling for a home. Sometimes in a market you may bargain, but in a shop you usually know the price and pay. Problems in the international markets are the countries that may want your goods may have anything that you want so you cannot barter or exchange. The country therefore has to buy in cash, and this presents problem. Buying at home, you use the same currency in Pakistan, rupees of course, but in worldwide trading, each country has its own currency. And the value of this compared with other currencies exchanges from day to day, often from hour to hour. Today, this problem is solved by agreeing to use one currency for international trading, the most common being the US dollar. Sometimes the trade is direct. Japan needs oil for its industry but has none of its own. Saudi Arabia has plenty of oil but does not have an industrial base producing heavy machinery, motor cars, and electronic goods. This obvious answer for these two countries is to exchange goods with cash if the two do not balance. Sometimes the trading is a bit more complicated, as shows in the drawing below. This drawing you can see on your screen as well. Here's the end of the chapter. Let's start doing the exercises. Your question number one is, why is it important for a country to balance its import? It is important for a country to balance its export and import because if a country imports more than its export, it has to borrow from international organizations like the World Bank and will have to prepay the loan with high interest. This means it will have less to spend on services such as schools, hospitals, law and order, roads and stock. Your question number two is, how many rupees would you get for? US dollar 1, we will get 1672.5 rupees. For sterling pounds, 10 pounds, we will get 2141.94 rupees. For 50 Saudi riyals, we get 2232.24 rupees. For 100 Japanese yen, we will get 157.76 rupees. For 50 Iranian riyals, we get 0.20 rupees. 10 Singapore dollars, we will get 1210.99 rupees. For 10 euros, we get 1951.80 rupees. Here is the question number 3. Find out and list the raw materials that Pakistan imports for its industries. Also list the finished products that are imported from abroad into Pakistan. Some imported raw materials are petroleum and petroleum products, plastic, fertilizers, chemicals, synthetic yarns, wheat, soya beans and palm oils, iron and steel. Some important imported finished products are power generating and mining machinery, textile, agriculture and electrical machinery, electronic appliances and apparatus, petroleum products, transport vehicles and equipments including aircraft, paper, electronic and electrical equipments. Your question number 4. How have Pakistanis working abroad helped the economy? Pakistani working abroad earn much higher wages than what they can earn here in Pakistan. They send home money and thus help the economy of the country. Your question number 5. What will happen if a country imports more than it exports? So the answer is the country will be in debt and will have to borrow money at high interest. In question number 6, you have to match the currencies to the countries. You have to tell the pound sterling is the currency of Britain. Dollar is the currency of USA. Euro is the currency of Europe. Yen is the currency of Japan. And Rial is the currency of Saudi Arabia. In question number 7, from the business pages of the newspaper, find out and write the rupee exchange rate for each currency in the table above. Dear students, you have to do this question by your own and then you compare your answers with the answer I'm going to give over here. For pound sterling is 121.10 rupees we will get. For US dollar we have 167.45. For euro we have 195.18. For yen 1.58. For Saudi Arabia we will get 44.64. Okay. In question number 8, you have to complete the statements. The value of exports and imports set against one another is called balance of payment. A country which sells more than it buys has a spare balance of trade. A country which buys more than it sells has a low balance of trade. Another source of income for a country is the money sent home by the overseas people. In 2001, the Pakistani emigrants sent home about $2 billion. Here's the end of the chapter. So if you find any difficulty, please ask from me. Thank you.